What is up, guys? Kid Kritic is back with the fifth episode of the Kid Kritic Movie Podcast, where we talk about movies and all that other fun stuff. And today, we got a special episode. I mean, every episode, as I've said millions of times before, of the Kid Kritic Movie Podcast is special. But this time, Kid Kritic is not alone. Kid Kritic has a guest. And no, it is not English Kid Kritic. This is a new person who might be a part of the Kid Kritic family. We just don't know yet, but it was a fun time. However, I do give this brief warning. The audio was not the best. However, we tried our very, 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 very best to finally get this podcast uploaded, and this was the best we can do. So hopefully you guys will enjoy it as much as we did making it, either though it was the most stressful thing that Kid Kritic has probably ever done. But we go over some great topics, we recap a little bit more about Comic-Con, we talk about the Toronto International Film Festival, and a bunch of other fun stuff. So without further ado, start that intro. We are on the fifth episode of the Kid Kritic Movie Podcast. It's been an exhausting week, so I needed a guest to carry on a little bit of this talking. The John Williams to my Steven Spielberg. He is. You heard him laugh right now. Graham.
Is good.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty well.
Taking an hour to start this. Can you believe that?
I really can, because I just spent the entire hour with you doing that.
That's why you're the John Williams to my Steven Spielberg. All right. Without further ado, start talking. All right. First of all, I have two questions for you.
Yes.
Question is, do you take your phone out during a movie?
No, never.
Do you take a picture of the screen during the movie?
No.
Because somebody we know has done that.
Somebody we know has done that, and I don't know, it makes me a little mad. A little disrespectful. the filmmakers, you know?
Yeah, no, like, the heck. Anyways, my second question. What did you think of this year's Comic-Con?
I mean, I thought it was pretty great. It felt a little weird not having Warner Brothers, like, / DC there. Because there's no Wonder Woman or anything like that. The MCU panel was interesting. It was a little tiring. I feel like I'm a little fatigued from it because we just went through the Infinity Saga.
But this one feels different, though. But this one feels different.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. I think Shang-Chi will be interesting, because are they bringing back the Mandarin for that?
Yes, they are bringing back the Mandarin. The real Mandarin. Now, are you a fan of the Mandarin in Iron Man 3?
I didn't mind it. Obviously, it's not what it is in the comics, but if you're going to the movie expecting the movie to be exactly how it is in the comics, then it's not. Like, obviously, that's not going to happen. So, I was fine with it. Whatever.
You see, they just said Ben Kingsley as a Mandarin so well that when they killed it.
Yeah. I feel like
no.
If they had started off and said that the other guy was the Mandarin and they switched it and it became Ben Kingsley was the actual Mandarin, it could have been better. Kind of how they did it in Batman Begins with Ra's al Ghul. You had like the not comic accurate Ra's al Ghul, and they said, this guy's Ra's al Ghul. But then they flipped it, and it's like, oh yeah, well the Liam Neeson Ra's al Ghul is more comic accurate anyway, so
it makes sense. Or you just don't need to flip it at all, and just leave that.
Yeah, yeah. And
there, because that first half of Iron Man 3 is like
golden.
Yeah, it is gold, and the second half is like I want to leave.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. Doctor Strange could be good.
I think that one
might be my it's up there for my most hyped of Phase 4.
I have Shang-Chi, but the multiverse, it could be fun. I think it's gonna be fun, but I'm not a fan of the multiverse. Okay. The only multiverse I've been a fan of is Spider-Man to the Spider-Verse, which is a fantabulous movie.
Yeah. I think that well, because the director, Scott Derrickson, I think I said that
yes.
Right.
Yes, Scott Derrickson.
He said it was going to be like a horror movie, which has me intrigued. So I think they could do something different there, which is interesting. I think the Thor Love and Thunder is my most hyped one on the list.
I'm also excited for that, but I've said this before, we've seen in the past that when directors come back in the MCU, it hasn't turned out very well. There's a big difference between Iron Man 1 and Iron Man 2.
I definitely agree with that, but I think that was the early MCU, and I think they have more of a vision of what they're going for, and more of like a, they have more experience with it, I guess. So I'm hyped for this.
But
which one's your most hyped one?
Oh, for me, Shang-Chi, hands down, because the Mandarin and the cast looks fantastic, and I like the director. Have you seen the writer?
Mm-mm.
It came out like 2 years ago, but it's about this bullfighter. It's a true story, and it's really good. So that's why I'm excited. If you haven't seen it, gotta go see it. It is fantastic.
No, yeah, I think this one's going to be cool, because I mean, it's not what we've seen before with, you know, like space battle or end of the world. I think it's going to be more like Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon type. It'll be cool.
What do you think of the TV series?
I mean, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier could be good. I think
that looks fantastic.
What If could be funny and interesting. Yeah. The cast on that is insane. They have like everyone that's ever been in a Marvel movie.
Yeah. Keep in mind, it's voice acting.
Well, yeah.
Voice.
Animated, of course.
Yeah. Still excited, though.
Hawkeye could be...
Hawkeye's interesting.
Interesting. I'm not really excited for the Loki one.
Really?
I mean, I guess it could be... It could be good, but I'm kind of tired of seeing a bunch of Loki stuff. I think we should focus on different characters. That's why I'm kind of excited for Hawkeye and the Falcon and the Winter Soldier, because it's something new. Loki's gotten his movies.
I'm tired of them bringing back Loki. They took, because they killed him off in Thor 2, and then they killed him off again, killed him off again in Infinity War, and I thought, there, just die already.
Yeah, when is this? This is in the alternate universe, right? Loki, I think it's the one that he created in Endgame, that Loki, when he took the space down.
Is that Loki?
Alright,
that's why I don't want a multiverse, because it's like, bring back Vision while you're at it, bring back Mindo while you're at it.
It does feel a little, like, cheap around that, yeah. Blade? That one I'm pretty hyped for.
It not being rated R, because it's not going to be rated R.
Yeah, I mean, that'll be interesting, because Blade is very intense. The first couple ones were pretty hard R, right?
But keep in mind, Blade is with vampires, and usually when it comes to like vampires and robots and all that, and cuts from like that doesn't. If you see in the Transformers movies, Optimus Prime slicing down Transformers, that's not rated R.
Yeah.
Unless it's humans. So.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, Mahershala Ali as Blade is brilliant. I love Mahershala. Dude, he's like one of my favorite.
That casting is perfect.
What's your favorite performance of his?
It's definitely not Green Book, I'll tell you that.
Really? Why?
He was fine in Green Book, but Green Book is
fine?
Green Book is such a cookie cutter, like Oscar bait movie. I hate that.
What? Oh my god. Oh, I love that movie. That movie's so good. It was one of my favorites. Yes, I love that movie. I don't know, he was really good in Moonlight.
Yeah.
Did you ever see him in Luke Cage?
I did. I was just going to bring this up. Well, now that they cast him for Blade, does that mean that the Netflix shows are just not, like, we're just ignoring those completely now?
They're ignoring that a long time ago. But, spoiler alert for Luke Cage, I watched until he died, and I was like, okay, I'm done.
Oh, yeah. the show got bad after that. Like, trust me. Like, yeah, that's sad, though. I like Daredevil a lot.
And Daredevil. A lot of people give a hard time to Season 3. Season 3 of Daredevil was, like, my favorite.
Oh, yeah. I love it. Oh, my God. It's so well written.
John Bernthal is the Punisher.
That is really embarrassing. Speaking of John Bernthal, he was also in The Walking Dead for a couple seasons. And that panel was interesting. I didn't look too into it because I stopped
watching. Are you still into it?
I started watching just a couple weeks ago, so I'd like just got into it, and so I'm only on the end of season 4.
Oh,
that's where I am. Yeah.
Like, am I allowed to spoil it?
No, you are not.
I stopped watching when a particular death happened in the middle of season 8. I was like off and on. Like, I watched half of season 6.
I think
six,
I know who you're talking about, but just don't say anything. Do you see the Halloween, the announcements about the Halloween movies?
Yes, I did.
It's Halloween. Halloween Kills and Halloween Ends.
And Halloween Ends.
That I don't like those titles.
Well, I mean, we've seen a lot of titles with ends, and later a new sequel comes out, so I don't think that ended very much.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like they're just kind of milking it at this point. Like, the newer one was pretty good. I think the original.
There's some stuff
the
that
one.
I did not like. Oh yeah, hands down. Actually, I think Halloween 2 is underrated. That's a guilty pleasure. I love watching that.
Really, I haven't seen that one.
When they're in the hospital.
Mm-mm. I saw the first one, and I saw the remake that they just or the reboot, I guess.
No, a lot of people give up to the third one too. Either though, Michael Myers is an idiot. But they did in that movie. That just like I didn't like what they did with that doctor guy.
Yeah.
No, not cool.
All right, what's next?
Did you see that there might be a chance, however, that Deadpool might go into the MCU?
Oh yeah, totally. I think it's gonna happen. And I think it's gonna be rated R.
Because the person who handles the superhero genres and all that left to go handle the Avatar movies that they're making a billion of, to go handle that. So then Deadpool's getting carried off to Marvel. Now she better not go into the MCU because. Like, people are complaining, oh, Venom must be R, Blade must be R. No, they don't need to be R, but Deadpool is all rated R. Like, his cuss words and everything, his raunchiness, that is rated R. That, he does not fit in the MCU at all.
Oh, yeah, for sure. No, I think what they're doing is Disney and Marvel, they own a separate company. I'm blanking on the name right now. But that's how they're releasing Deadpool, and they're making it in like a separate universe. I think
I read about Fox.
Are you talking about
the other franchise?
No, it's not like a big, it's like a semi like indie company, and they're I read somewhere that they might be
Fox
releasing it through that, and that's how they're making the radar, and it's gonna be like a separate thing.
I thought they just put Fox over it, but
I mean, they could do that too.
It just makes no sense because that's a lot of continuity errors. Because he's been, I mean, they haven't. This Colossus is already there. A bunch of you made fun of the X-Men so many times. This makes no sense, but
yeah,
let's just hope not. Nah.
No, I think Kevin Feige is smart enough to keep it in the R. Like its own separate universe.
I don't think he'd handle those movies, though. I think he just handles the MCU.
Well, now that they bought them, don't you think? Because they're doing Fantastic Four, too. That was one of the announcements at the end.
Oh, yeah, the Fantastic Four and X-Men, but Deadpool's a different story. To move on to some sadder news, the death has occurred this week. Rutger Hauer has passed away, obviously known for his work in Blade Runner. Now, I'm actually not the biggest fan of Blade Runner. I like Blade Runner, but I'm not the biggest fan. I think he's awesome in the movie, but I much prefer Blade Runner 2049 over it.
Yeah, I agree. I think the original Blade Runner is... Well, did you see the theatrical version or the director's cut?
See the director's cut of Blade Runner?
Yeah.
No, I haven't.
Okay, so this is like a whole story. There was some like mix up with the studio, and so there's a theatrical release, a director's cut. There's literally like 7 cuts of the movie. It's insane.
Yeah,
but the director's cut is there
a Snyder cut of this?
Yeah, release the Snyder cut. Do you know that Rutger Hauer was in Batman Begins?
Yes, I didn't know that. Dude.
That's pretty cool.
And he's also, I mean. What age did he pass away at? You know?
I don't know. I think he was it 70s or
60s? Yeah, I mean.
Yeah. That last monologue of Blade Runner was like my favorite part of the movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't seen a movie in a long time.
Really? I saw it a couple months ago.
I haven't seen it in like 2 years. Blade Runner 2049.
Dude, that movie is beautiful.
It is beautiful. A little bit too long. But yeah. Anyways, let's move on to some more happier news. You know, movie's coming out this weekend and it goes by the name of Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, directed by the one and only Quentin Tarantino, starring Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, and Margot Robbie. Now, are you seeing this movie?
Yeah, I am. I was actually going to see it this weekend, but I couldn't because we have just other family stuff going on, so kind of disappointed about that, but we might be seeing it, me and my dad, the next week.
Well, you know what you can see?
What's that?
You can see the review of Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, which will be up tomorrow. So, I have a question.
Yeah.
How much money do you think this movie is going to make opening weekend? And keep in mind, the biggest opening weekend for a Tarantino movie was $38 million.
$38 million.
I'm thinking 60.
Yeah, I'm going to say, is that true? The biggest is $38 million. That's insane. What was this movie's budget? Do I know?
I don't know. But this movie has a huge cap.
Probably around like $50 million.
I'm going to think $65 million. I think it's going to blow it out of the water. It's already made $5 million for Thursday night screenings. Yeah, so my guess is $5 million.
Yeah. That's pretty fair. Did you see, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Oh, thank you. No, I was just going to say, Maya Hawke is in the cast. You know her from Stranger Things Season 3. She's Robin.
Oh, yeah.
And a lot of people were kind of bashing her being cast in the movie because of nepotism for her mom being in Kill Bill and, like, you know, Tarantino favorite.
Tarantino picks whoever he wants, and if he thought she was good,
yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
She's good. So I mean, the cast is I mean, I hear like some big, huge star pops in for 5 seconds and then leaves. So she might be in there for a half of a scene and leave. But did you hear the rumors that Jack Nicholson might show up in this movie?
No, I didn't. That's interesting.
Oh, if he shows up, because I'm a huge Jack fan. Oh my God, I'd cry. Do you think, though, that Tarantino will make more than 10 movies?
No.
No.
No way.
Because he's talking about Kill Bill 3, Star Trek, and not...
I think he's definitely going to be a producer for those films, but I don't think he's going to direct it.
No.
Aren't they making a Django Unchained 2? Or whatever?
I mean, I've heard talks about that, but I don't think that's going to... Well, I mean, he's already been talking to Uma Thurman about Kill Bill 3,
I'm talking to my hawk too.
Apparently he's been talking to the whole family. But anyways, I do think he'll make more than 10. I see why he wants to make more than 10, but why make more than 10? Who cares if you make 10 movies? Who cares?
Okay, yeah. I mean, if he has a good story, like something really good, I don't think he'll back away from that, but I think he wants not to, like, stretch himself out too much.
He's not even that old. He's young. I mean, what's his face? Clint Eastwood is, like, 800 years old, and he's starring in making movies. But, anyways. So what's your favorite Tarantino movie?
You already know the answer.
I don't know the answer, actually.
Yeah, we texted this. I haven't seen a Tarantino movie.
I just need you to say that.
I know you are. You better edit that out. So
that's insane.
Yeah.
So hold on. So you're telling me you've never seen Reservoir Dogs?
No. And I'm a film.
You've never seen. You've never seen Pulp Fiction.
No.
You've never seen Django Unchained.
Okay, that one I've heard is not that good.
Like, what?
One of his worst movies.
Who told you that? Whoever told you that is an absolute liar. That's my second. Oh my God. Oh my
wait,
God.
Wait, I want to hear. I want to hear your ranking for them.
Like my rankings?
Yeah. What's your ranking?
I haven't seen all of these. I haven't seen Jackie Brown or Kill Bill. So
okay.
But how I would rank number one in Glorious Bastards, absolutely brilliant.
All
right. I go Django Unchained. Then I go Reservoir Dogs. Then I go Pulp Fiction. No, I'm screaming at the computer screen because I said Pulp Fiction was fourth.
Is that all?
Yeah, because I started watching Hateful Eight. It's so long that I'm yet to see it. That's how my ranking would get. Upon Time in Hollywood ends up in there. But if I would start off at the very, I would start off with the Reservoir Dogs, and then work up from there throughout his list. That's where I would start. Reservoir Dogs is, woo! I have it on Blu-ray, and it's great. So, you know what else is great?
What?
That Cats trailer.
Oh yes, 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 100% agree. Such a meme.
I didn't even see it came out on YouTube. So when I went to go watch Lion King, the trailers came. These human cat creatures got two legs come up out of nowhere. Like, what is this? This is horrifying. I'm not here to see a scary movie. I'm gonna watch The Exorcist. The trailer and it ended up being Cats, which is a well-known play.
I actually, I've never seen the play, and I've like, I don't know what the story is about, but I'm really interested now.
But I gotta admit though, I watched the trailer a couple more times. The special hit are glorious.
On the cats or like the surrounding, like the background?
The cats.
Really? You think that they were good?
Yeah. I mean, not like Lion King good.
No, I mean, I was studying it, and I think the face from the actors who like obviously don't have the body that is there. It's like, I don't know, the proportions with like the ears and the eyebrows, they just look unnatural to me.
Somebody who does not pay attention to the cat's bodily figure.
Well, no. I was just trying to figure out why it's super like uncanny valley, because it's like a weird blend of like the ears are where the cat ears are, but then there's like the eyes that are human and like the mouth that's human. There's just something so off-putting about it. I don't know. But the movement, like their actual movement when they're like dancing around and moving, it looks fluid. It looks fine.
I'll say at the least, I'm a bit interested. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, I'm super interested. I really want to see it. Like, I'm not even being ironic about it. I like.
Either I like the special effects more than you did.
I guess you did. I mean, I think they nailed like the lighting on the cats and like all that. Technically, I guess it looks fine, but it's just there's something off-putting about it. It's from what's the director's name? Tom Hooper?
Yeah, Tom Hooper. He directed Les Mis.
Yeah. So
I'm not a big music person. I got a confession to make though. It's probably worse than your
Tarantino.
Yeah. I've never seen Gone with the Wind.
Oh, really?
I've never seen Gone with the Wind. It's a long movie.
No, I'm kidding. I've never seen it either.
it's like a four-hour movie.
So many movies I need to see. Like, so many classic movies I need to see.
What else people have been seeing? Spider-Man Far From Home. It has made $1 billion, folks. That's right. The first Spider-Man movie to ever make $1 billion. Accidentally spelled Far From Home wrong. I put Fat From Home.
Nice.
But anyways, it made $1 billion. Now, it's actually my second favorite Spider-Man movie. I still have Spider-Verse at number one.
Dude, I can't believe Spider-Verse is at the bottom of, like, box office-wise.
Well, because, I mean, it's an animated Marvel movie. Not many people
know
that.
That's such a disappointment. Because, like, if you look at the quality from that to, like, Amazing Spider-Man 2 or like Spider-Man.
The quality of the cast trailer compared to Amazing Spider-Man 2 is like Godfather tier.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, a lot is better than Amazing Spider-Man 2, but that's actually not even my least favorite Spider-Man. I have Spider-Man 3. That movie's god awful. The only thing good about that movie is Sandman. Other than that,
I think that one scene with Sandman where he first becomes Sandman redeems itself for me. To above Amazing Spider-Man 2. That's my opinion.
Anyways, what did you think of Far From Home?
I thought it was pretty good. Yeah, I like Mysterio. Jake Gyllenhaal is great.
More than Homecoming?
I've been thinking about this, and I'm not sure. I honestly don't know. I really liked Homecoming because it just felt like super small scale. I don't know. I really liked the Vulture. I think that was a good twist.
Yeah.
It was a better twist than I think Michael the Mysterio Kena twist the was.
Oh yeah, easily, because that wasn't expected.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wait, were we allowed to say there's a twist with Mysterio?
Well, spoilers.
Spoilers for Spider-Man Far From Home. Mysterio.
I mean, who hasn't seen it? That's watching this podcast.
Yeah, no, made $1 billion. Spoiler. Mysterio has a beard. There's your twist, folks. Anyways, Anyways, I had a conversation with somebody, and they said that as Spider-Man 2, you've seen Spider-Man 2, right?
Of course.
Have you seen that? Okay. If Spider-Man 2 had come out now, they said a Spider-Man 2 would make $1 billion. Now, I said...
I disagree.
No chance
Spider-Man 2 makes $1 billion.
And here's why. Because when Spider-Man 2 came out, the only superhero franchises you had were X-Men, and then Batman started coming around again.
Mm-hmm.
Those were only franchises you had. And it was a different era. This comic book genre nowadays has totally evolved from Spider-Man 2. Because if you look at that movie's corny.
Yeah, but that's part of the charm of it. It came out the right time, and I feel like now most of the Spider-Man movies look completely different, like just visually. There's so
not
much
just
more
Spider-Man movies,
like VFX.
Every
superhero movie is so much more VFX heavy than the original Spider-Man and Spider-Man 2.
But, it still made a lot of money. It made it like $800 million, so you can't take that away. But you know what else, though, I saw that I have, and I meant to talk about this last week, but I forgot. So, it's on CNN, and it's called The Movies. It's actually produced by Tom Hanks. Love me some Tom Hanks. And it basically goes over decades of movies. Like, last weekend was the 2000s to now. And then this weekend, they're doing the 70s. And then they did the 90s as well. Huh. It's actually a really cool show if you want to know more about the decades. I mean, they go over the big movies.
Yeah.
And it's really, really interesting. I mean, you have people like Steven Spielberg on there. And it's absolutely crazy. Yeah.
They have a lot of people. Documentary type?
They interview them. That is a really cool show. Highly recommend it. So with that said, what is your favorite decade of movies?
My favorite decade of movies?
Yes.
I mean, if we're going by nostalgia, early 2000s, because that's when I was born, and obviously, but I don't know. That's the thing. I need to see more movies. I guess what I'm thinking about, I don't know, either the 80s or the this past decade.
I'm a tie between the 80s and the 70s. The 70s was... Oh my god, it was huge. The 80s, you got a bunch of classics. I mean, you have Empire Strikes Back, Back to the Future, E.T., a bunch of Spielberg movies. And in the 70s, you have the... You have The Godfather, the first Star Wars. I think Star Trek Wrath of Khan came out that decade, or maybe the decade after. It's packed decade, but I think I'm gonna go 80s.
Alright, cool.
Yeah. Anyways, let's move on from that. You know, a big, big topic, or a big piece of news came out today, and that is Ben Affleck and Matt Damon are re-teaming after the Oscar-winning screenplay in a movie that they starred in called Good Will Hunting. Have you seen Good Will Hunting?
I've seen parts of it.
You've seen parts of it?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, but really the last time they're together?
That's the last time they wrote a movie.
Huh.
Movie is directed by Ridley Scott.
Wow.
But they're writing this with, I'm probably going to mess up her name, by Nicole Fissener. I'm not going to try that. But she's a pretty good writer. I mean, she wrote Can You Ever Forgive Me, which was pretty good. She directed Enough Said, which I hear is pretty good. And she directed a bunch of other stuff. So that's pretty good. Now, the movie is basically about, it's set in the 14th century in France, and it's based off of a book that's called The Duo to End All Duos, and it's between a knight and a courtier, and it's basically with a knight called Jean du, butcher this thing too, the Glorious, returns from the battle in Scotland. He discovers that his wife has a friend of raping, impregnating her, which has to deny the claims, and then leads to a duel between Ben Affleck and Matt Damon.
Wow.
Now, that sounds...
That's a story right there.
It's very dark. Oh, by the way, the book is not called The Duel to End All Duels. It's called The Last Duel.
Okay.
That's what the book's called. It's something new. I'll say that much.
Yeah. Definitely haven't heard of that before. Ridley Scott's directing it, right?
Yeah, so I mean,
that'll be cool.
He's been hit and miss.
Yeah.
The Alien movies have been directed The Martian, which is great, but
I love The Martian.
It is interesting. Let's see what will happen. I mean, last time they wrote was Good Will Hunting, which is crazy. I love that movie. The movie's fantastic. Maybe there'll be some cameos from that movie. Maybe we'll see Minnie Driver pop up in there. Who knows? Anyways, let's move on to the next topic of news. You know something that came out today? And it was fantastic. I love this. Whoa. The new Zombieland 2 Double Tap trailer.
Yesterday.
Has come out. Yesterday, yes, I know.
Oh, I thought you said today. My bad.
I said today? Oh, whatever. Anyways, the Zombieland Double Tap trailer came out. You can see my trailer reaction, by the way, on the Kid Kritic channel. If you have not visited that channel, it is a fantastic YouTube channel. Just make sure you subscribe and watch all the videos there. Anyways, it looks pretty, pretty wild. What did you think of this trailer?
I think it's going to be fun. It's going to be a pretty solid movie. I think the cast, I'm pretty surprised they got Emma Stone to come back.
Why, because she's...
Yeah, she seems a little, like, above this. Because she was in the first one, that was, like, the beginning of her career, kind of.
Wait, I gotta confirm this. You've seen the first Zombieland?
Yes.
Okay. I love that movie.
Yeah, I mean... I saw it a long time ago, though.
Are you a fan of Jesse Eisenberg?
I think he's a fine actor. I mean, obviously...
I think when he's in the right roles, he's
pretty good. Like...
He was also in there.
Was a little...
Yeah, that... Actually, if he wasn't playing Lex Luthor, a good performance.
Maybe if he was, like, a Riddler, that would have been fine.
Yeah,
I could see him as a Riddler, but, like, I don't know.
He was also in The Social Network, too.
Yeah, no. Yeah, definitely.
And then he also got Woody Harrelson.
For that?
Did he get knocked?
No.
I think he... No.
I don't know.
Let me see.
The movie got nominated.
Yeah,
it got beat out by Tom Hooper's other movie.
Yeah, that movie. We also got Woody Harrelson coming back. He just looks great. He looks absolutely fantastic. What are the odds that Bill Murray comes back?
20%. There's a 20% chance. I think it's low. Because hasn't he said, maybe I'm confusing him with someone else, but hasn't he said something where he's like, I don't want to come back for, like, sequels or something like that?
Well,
I might be confusing him with someone else, honestly.
There's rumors about him coming back.
Okay. Well, if he is, then I'd be down.
I gotta be honest, though. Oh, he was nominated for Best Actor by
Jesse Eisenberg?
Yes.
Okay.
And... I actually kind of forgot this movie's coming out this year because nobody's been talking about it. I'm very excited for it. You know what else I'm very excited for?
What's that?
The new Ang Lee movie starring your buddy old pal Will Smith, Gemini Man.
Yeah, I saw your reaction on this, and you're pretty stoked for this.
Hey guys, make sure you check out the trailer reaction on my YouTube channel. All right, cool. All right, I like this trailer. Do you like this trailer?
It's definitely better than the first one. I hate the first trailer because it was played at every single movie theater. For every single movie that I saw, this trailer would pop up.
You feel like me with the Terminator trailer. Like, I'm tired of
that. Oh, yeah. The new one?
Yeah. So you didn't like this trailer. So do you like it or dislike it?
I'm kind of in between on it. I thought it was kind of funny how they played a Jaden Smith song in a Will Smith movie.
I didn't even notice that, to be honest.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice that was a song.
Yeah. I mean, I think that the CGI with young Will Smith looks pretty good, but other than that, the movie, I don't know, it has, like, this cheaper feeling to me.
But that's crazy. I mean, that looks like, I said in my reaction, that looks like Independence Day Smith.
It reminds me of Samuel Jackson in Captain Marvel.
Yeah, that was also done very well. But I'm very excited for it. I mean... The premise seems like, I mean, we've seen it before, but the action looks fantastic.
Yeah, I think with Ang Lee, it's either going to be really good, or at the least, it's going to be, like, just a fun action film. Like, just a popcorn movie.
I don't know. We'll see.
It has a lot of potential.
It does have. Will Smith also looks very good in it.
Did you see The Life of Pi?
You suck. You suck.
Dude, that movie's really good.
Really? I'd never heard that before.
Are you serious?
No, I'm joking. It's sarcasm.
Oh my god.
Anyways, let's move on from that nonsense. You know, some sort of traditional film.
Sorry.
You know what? I'm done. You know what? This is your show now. Goodbye. I'm leaving. Anyways, the Toronto International Film Festival, which is in Toronto, because I don't know, has released their first lineup of movies at the Toronto International Film Festival, and they got a stacked lineup. Like, if you want to go here, it is stacked. So the really? First one you got, yes.
Yeah, I stayed away from this because I knew that we were going to talk about it here. So.
So this is a surprise.
What?
So this is a surprise for
yeah,
you?
Yeah, yeah, hit me. Go.
All right, so the first one you got, A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. This is the Mr. Rogers. Did you see the trailer?
I did.
Probably?
It looks pretty good.
Yeah, well, Tom Hanks, oh my god. Did you see the documentary?
Oh yeah, that was great.
Oh my god. How was it not nominated at the Oscars?
Know. That, yeah, I agree. No, I think, Hanks is going to get nominated? Probably, right?
I mean, he looks... Yeah. So you have... The next one you have is Knives Out, which is the Rian Johnson movie. Right. That movie was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'm excited.
You like the...
Yeah.
That one?
I think the Captain cast America. Is insane.
Yeah, the cast is absolutely insane. You got James Bond and Captain America in the same movie?
Did you watch Snowpiercer with Chris Evans?
I've seen parts.
Oh,
and it looked good.
So good.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, he's great in that, so I'm excited.
Now, this next movie, I did a trailer action for this movie not so long ago, and it goes by the name of... Jojo Rabbit, which is directed
by Taika
Waititi.
Dude. I love Taika Waititi so much. He's
the trailer looks absolutely insane.
He's one of my favorite directors. Period.
He's not... I mean, he's really good, but he's not one of my favorite. Like, right now, I'd
have
probably...
Go.
Like, right now, I'd probably put up, like, a Christopher Nolan, a Tarantino, a Denis Villeneuve, Ryan Coogler. I think I'd put them above him.
Okay. Have you seen Hunt for the Wilder People?
No, I really want to, and I've been trying to look for ways to watch it, but
it's pretty great. It's on Hulu, so that's where I watch it. I watched it a couple days ago. It's really great, but I'm excited for this one. I like the point that you made on your reaction. You said like how he was going from the big blockbuster like Ragnarok to a small indie movie.
Now another one that I'm. Very excited for is Ford versus Ferrari. They're premiering that there too. Directed by James Mangold, who directed Logan, one of my favorite comic book movies of all time. And you have Christian Bale, Matt Damon in there. The trailer is awesome for this movie.
Yeah, I'm excited. It's gonna be.
And then let's see what else we got. This I'm also excited for. It's a movie called Just Mercy, which is now another one that's coming. Is The Goldfinch, which is starring Ansel Elgort, has like a beautiful cast. Have you seen the trailer for this movie?
I have not.
I have no clue what this movie's about. However, it does look really good because the cast looks great. You have Nicole Kidman in there and a bunch of other people I can't remember because that's just too big cast. And I liked the trailer. I just don't have a clear idea on what the movie's about. So, anyways, now you have another movie here, which is called Honey Boy, which you got the great Shia LaBeouf in there. I think he's an underrated actor, actually. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Did you see the movie that he's in called...
Is that the Peanut Butter one?
Yeah, Peanut Butter at Night.
Dude, that movie looks really good.
Yeah,
that
movie does look good. Now, the big name, that is Joker. Joker will be at the Toronto Film Festival.
Really?
That trailer for that movie is one of my favorite trailers of the year. It's probably my favorite trailer of the year.
It looks pretty sweet.
Now, the other night, I watched Taxi Driver. Have you seen Taxi Driver? Robert De Niro? No?
Just keep talking. No, yeah, just keep talking.
No, I want to know if you've seen Taxi Driver.
No, I have not. I mean, you said that you just saw it, so...
Anyways, I'm very disappointed.
It's on my list. It's on my list.
So, I was watching Taxi Driver, and people were saying, oh, Joker's going to be like Taxi Driver, And I watched Taxi Driver, and I see it because I'm not going to put spoilers for Taxi Driver, which came out in, like, 1975. But Robert De Niro's character, let's just say he gets crazier and crazier. Yeah. As I definitely... The Joker trip, I mean, you see him get crazier and crazier.
It looks great. And the director, what's his name?
Todd Phillips. He made The Hangover.
Right. I think he said somewhere, maybe on Instagram, but he wasn't taking any inspiration from any comic book. And that got me excited. Because it's going to be something super original and new. And I don't know, it looks intense.
It's going to be like Scorsese-esque.
Well, he's producing it, right? I'm pretty sure Scorsese's producing it.
Is he really?
Yeah.
I don't know that.
Pretty sure.
But Robert De Niro's also in it. He looks just brilliant.
And Joaquin Phoenix?
Do you think he'll get nominated?
If you're a Joker?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's tough. I'm going to say, for right now, no. Just because it's super rare for that to happen in a comic book movie. But at the same time, it's Joaquin Phoenix, and this movie's completely different. And also, he's in one of my favorite movies ever, Her. That movie's...
That's probably your favorite movie of all time, really?
Oh, yeah. Well, probably like top 10, top 5.
What's your favorite performance of all time?
Ooh. That's tough.
I have mine.
Really?
Yeah. What is it? My brilliant movie. Have you seen There Will Be Blood?
Oh, are you saying Daniel Day-Lewis?
Daniel Day-Lewis.
Yeah.
Oh my god. He is haunting. That is best performance I've seen in my life.
Come back to me next week when I'm on the podcast. Wink, wink. No, I'm kidding. Just give me
time. I watch Tarantino movies after.
Yeah, if you give me time to think about that, maybe I'll come back and tell you. But for right now, I'm just going to say Dwayne Johnson in The Tooth Fairy.
You know something about that Tooth Fairy movie?
Yeah?
I watched The Tooth Fairy. And I was a smaller human when I watched The Tooth Fairy. Well, I mean, I don't have the mind that I do now, but now thinking about The Tooth Fairy does stink a little bit.
Dude, we watched it in English class last year. Oh my god, it's pretty awful. But it's also the best movie of all time, so there's that too.
Sure. I think Tom Lazzo in The Room, the best performance of all time for you.
Yeah.
Take acting classes. Jeez. Best performance of all time.
Have you seen The Disaster Artist?
Yes, I have seen The Disaster Artist. It was very good. I didn't love it as much as other people did, but it was a very... very good movie. But you know what else is very good?
What's that?
Aladdin has made $1 billion.
Get out of here.
I swear. You didn't know? Wait, what?
No. I knew that. But get out of here saying you know what else is very good. I was expecting like some like good movie, but then you said Aladdin. I know you liked it though, right? You liked the remake of it?
You didn't like Aladdin?
The remake?
Yes.
I mean, no. I thought okay. The actress who played Princess Jasmine was good.
Really? Why? Well, why?
I mean, she has a pretty good voice.
I don't think she just has a pretty good voice. I don't think that's what you were trying to say. Anyways, I liked Aladdin. Seeing the trailers when they first came out, I'm like, this movie's not gonna make $1 billion. I mean, I didn't mind the trailers.
Said that?
I mean, I didn't actually say that out loud, but no way this movie's gonna make $1 billion.
Yeah, okay.
I just, because there's so much backlash, Will Smith was off Blueberry, which I did say that.
No, you know what? The Will Smith Genie CGI reminds me a lot of the Cats CGI.
I actually didn't mind the CGI. That kind of worked for me.
No, I think it's similar, though, the way people both reacted and how it's kind of, like, off-putting slightly, but...
But Will Smith was a standout in that movie.
He was surprisingly good. I thought he was going to be the worst part of the movie, but he was actually...
I actually didn't mind him in the trailers, but, I mean, the first trailer, the best. The second trailer came out and showed us nothing. Then the Will Smith came out, and then the next trailer. What was it?
I was gonna say, I guess it's just a theme with Will Smith movies, because it's the same thing for Gemini Man.
Well, I mean, Aladdin's actually his biggest movie of all time. Really? That? Aladdin is, I mean, you have movies like Independence Day,
Men in Black never
Men
passed
in Black.
I guess Aladdin
has not even
passed
close.
1 billion.
Not even.
Yeah, that's true.
No, not even close. Men in Black, because I don't think it's even made $500 million.
Do you think the Avatar sequels are going to pass a billion?
Avatar 2? Yes. Not
3,
2,
4, 5?
That's how good Avatar 2 is. I mean, it's been more than a decade.
Yeah, I feel like everyone forgot about that movie. But there's a new... they're like making rides and stuff at Disney World for Avatar. So
the whole world thing?
They're trying to revive it. But I don't know if that's going to work.
That thing came out, like the Land of Pandora or whatever, came out like a couple years ago, didn't it?
And Disney World? Maybe. But I know that they just came out with a new ride.
Are you a fan of the first Avatar?
Looking at it from a technological standpoint, yeah. I think it's groundbreaking, but as far as it just being like a movie and looking at the story, yeah, it's all right.
Isn't the Avatar like really long? I haven't seen it in a long time, so I don't know. I forgot. I like the movie.
It probably just felt like that because of the story.
It felt oh my god, it's 2 hours and 42.
Yeah, wow.
That does not need to be that long. I dug it. I mean, visuals aside, actually, the movie. I mean, yeah. But with Aladdin, it's kind of like the same case I kind of was in with Aquaman, and it made a billion. I don't like that movie as much as other people did, though.
Aquaman?
It was fun.
I thought Shazam was better.
I mean, other than that, like, Shazam was way better.
Oh, yeah. Shazam, but I also like the director of Shazam, too. He's,
he's
on YouTube. And
yeah.
Yeah.
What's his face? Oh, I'm forgetting his name.
David F. Sandberg.
What's his name? Yeah, David Sandberg. Now that we got all those topics to talk about out of the way, let's get down to a new segment that has never been seen or heard of before.
Wow.
We're going to do a little bit
before, just period, or just on this podcast?
Oh, just period, like ever.
Oh, okay.
Ever.
All right.
Yeah. I'm like, let's do some fun games, because it's not just me anymore.
Yeah.
So,
oh, anymore?
Okay.
Are you inviting me back to the next podcast?
We'll see. We'll talk about it. We'll see after you watch those 10
I mean, I think your views are just going to spike up for this episode.
Absolutely. I've never seen a 10. No. Back to what I was saying before I was really interrupted by somebody who will not return.
Okay, yes, the game.
So we'll do some games. So I want to do two games. The first, the Sophie's Choice. You've done those?
Sorry, I was drinking water. What was that?
You know what? It's not cool. I invite you to be here. Anyways, have you ever done a Sophie's Choice?
No, what's that?
So this is basically... Well, you choose. So, I'm gonna give you two actors or directors.
That is a movie. Okay, sorry. It is a movie, though.
And it's gonna pertain. To the topics that we talked about.
Meryl Streep got she won an Oscar for that movie, by the way.
I don't care how many Oscars Meryl Streep won.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry. You can say it now. I'll allow it.
So you'll allow it. All right. Let's see how it is. So I'm gonna give you. I'll give you an actor or a director, two actors in this case, and you have to erase the other one from history. All right?
Okay.
You ready for this?
Yeah.
Since Once Upon a Time in Hollywood is out in theaters this weekend, Brad Pitt or Leonardo DiCaprio?
Brad Pitt. I'm erasing Brad Pitt. Keep Leonardo DiCaprio.
I agree. Alright, your next one. Al Pacino or Robert De Niro?
Oof.
I have an answer for this one.
Yeah? What's your answer? I want to hear your take on your own question.
I'd keep Robert De Niro, to be honest. I'd keep Robert De Niro.
Okay. I think... Yeah, I might have to go. I think I agree with you. He was in Raging Bull. He was in Cape Fear, which my dad actually worked on. And then...
You're famous.
Oh, yeah.
What do you do?
Dude, I'm famous. He was, I think he was assistant director on that.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's some.
He was also in, one of my favorite comedies, Meet the Fockers. Or Meet the Parents, I think is the first one. And then Meet the Fockers is the sequel.
One of your favorite comedies?
Oh, yeah.
I know it. That's in a million forever, too. Damn.
It's really good.
Your father's like, does he know Bob?
Yeah, I don't think he knows Bob. He has a comb that Nick Cage sent him.
Nick Cage, man. I haven't talked to that Nick in a long time. It's been a while.
Yeah.
I haven't talked to him since he did The Rock.
The Rock?
Yeah.
Oh, the movie. Yeah.
Yeah, The Rock. Okay. Not The Rock, The Rock. Because, you know, once he did those Ghost Rider movies, it's like...
Oh, yeah, you guys fell off.
Yeah, we fell off the tram. Like, nah, I can't have you hear me.
Okay.
All right. Next up. Margot Robbie or Emma Stone? I know what I'd choose for this one, too. I'd choose Margot Robbie.
Really? I was going to say Emma Stone.
I mean, it's not a bad pick either.
Yeah, they're both like... I don't know, that's pretty tough, but I think Emma Stone, just because I really like La La Land, and that movie's pretty great. But Margot Robbie also... is a really great actress, so I don't know. I'd have to. I don't really know. The thing is, I don't really know them as like people. I think Emma Stone's pretty chill in real life, but I don't really know Margot Robbie.
I've gone to parties with them. We've had.
Yeah.
We know each other.
Yeah.
Anyways, these are my two best friends. Like me? I hang out with them on a daily basis.
Is that
like
me?
No, I don't like you.
Oh.
These are my two best friends.
Yeah.
I just invited you on this podcast, by the way, just because you said you had nothing to do, and I'm like, you want to do this with me? You're like, sure.
Uh-huh.
But these are my two best friends. Will Smith or Tom Cruise? My two best friends?
I'm going to keep... Okay, wait, I thought I was going to say Tom Cruise, but now I'm thinking about it, and Will Smith has been in more... I feel like Will Smith always plays Will Smith. Yeah. If that makes sense.
I mean, have you seen The Pursuit of Happiness?
I've not.
He has a pretty darn good performance. And, I mean, this movie wasn't really talked about very much, but Concussion was really good. Seen that one? It came out not that long ago. Came out a couple of years ago. But I'd probably give it to my best friend, Tom Cruise. You know, he always had his struggles in the past, obviously.
I think
he has more of a range.
Yeah, and I also think he's done more for stunt special effects than Will Smith has done for, like, anything in general.
And he's been around longer, too.
But
we'll see.
Tom Cruise is older than
Tom Cruise has been around since... Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, a little bit older, but Tom Cruise has been around since, like, the 80s.
Huh.
Will Smith was early 90s, because Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Yeah. All right, now, let's see. What's the next one? All right. Now we're on to another game.
All
right. I'll give you a little bit of trivia. All right. I got three questions for you. Okay. The first question, you get choices. You get multiple choices.
Great. All right. Carrie's Choice.
Yes.
Deep's, Oscar-winning movie. Okay. Go ahead.
If I hear the name Meryl Streep one more time,
okay, yes,
I'm gonna lose it. Anyways, so your first question. How many Tarantino movies has Brad Pitt? Now, here are your options. Option number one, 3 movies. Option number 2 movies. Option number 3, 1 movie. Or option number 4 movies.
2 movies.
Got ourselves a winner, either though. He's seen a Tarantino movie. Yeah. That is right.
It was Inglourious Basterds movies. And Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, right?
Yes, it wasn't Glorious Bastards on time.
Got it. Easy.
All right. You know, a good buddy of mine goes by the name of Leonardo DiCaprio. How many Academy Award nominations does Leonardo DiCaprio have? Is it 2 nominations? Is it 5 nominations? Is it 6 nominations? Or is it 3 nominations?
Okay, it's definitely not that. It's the whatever the third option was. 6, I think?
6.
Yeah.
6?
Yeah.
That's what you're going for?
Yes.
The answer was 5. He has 5.
Okay, but 1 win, so 6.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, but it's the same.
Well, I didn't know if we were including wins and nominations.
But he still got nominated for that movie.
Yeah. Way. So wouldn't it be 6?
No.
He got 5 nominations, including the win as a nomination?
No, but not.
The win is not nomination. The nomination.
They still got. You know what? They're making it very confusing. He had 5 nominations, alright? He's nominated for The Revenant, which he won, okay?
Yeah.
He was nominated for Wolf of, was nominated for Blood Diamond. He was nominated for The Aviator, and he was nominated for his first time in 1994 for What's Eating Gilbert Grape.
Oh, okay. So you've
seen that movie?
Okay, yeah.
Have you seen that movie?
I haven't.
I like that movie.
Gilbert Grape.
It's pretty good. What's Eating Gilbert Grape? Pretty good.
Yeah. Okay.
Pretty good. Okay, this is the last question. And you have 1 minute to answer this.
Was I timed?
Actually, no, I lied. Hold on. Wait, hold on. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, like, whatever. Who cares? All right, so this is the second last question.
Okay.
What previous movie did Leonardo DiCaprio and Margot Robbie star in? Was it
Wolf of Wall
The Great
Street.
Gatsby?
Wolf of Wolf okay. Wall Street.
Okay. Answer the question.
That one's
okay.
Pretty easy.
I'll give you a minute for this one. Okay. You better not use Google. I swear if I hear it's typing, you're out.
Okay.
Name 5 of the 8, not including Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Name 5 of the 8 Tarantino.
Say it again.
I'll give you 1 minute.
Tarantino movies?
I'm just yes, them? Not including okay. not including Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
Ready?
Yes, go.
Reservoir Dogs. Inglourious Basterds, Django Unchained, Pulp Fiction, Kill Bill. Got it.
Can you name the other 3?
Are you including Kill Bill Volume 2? Or is that just one movie?
Well, I mean, Tarantino says one movie, but it's just for the
sake
of it, it's Kill Bill 2.
I don't know which ones I've already named.
Well, you're missing 2.
I am? What are the... What did I already say?
You said Reservoir Dogs, you said Kill Bill, and then you said Inglourious Bastards.
Okay.
You missed
Hateful Eight? No, right?
No.
Okay, Hateful Eight.
You're missing the last one.
Hold on.
Oh, your time was up a little
bit. What?
Jackie Brown.
Oh.
This is the last one. Anyways, folks, that does it. Where can the peoples find you on your social medias?
Ooh, okay. _ Graham Cracker on Instagram with 2 M's and 2 R's at the end of Cracker. And on YouTube, I am Squidport Productions.
And I gotta admit, you do some pretty solid videos that I have to admit is better than the Cats trailer. So, guys, for episode 5. So, you know, as always, look out for the next thing Kid Kritic does, whether it's a movie review, a trailer reaction, or another episode of the podcast. And make sure to subscribe to the Kid Kritic channel on YouTube if you haven't already. And with that said, guys, peace.